So a new feature in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote is now the ability to have all these options to reduce the file size. So if you have a lot of high resolution images and some video, you can do some things to make it a smaller file. I think this is going to be the most useful in Keynote, because Keynote is a lot of times where we pack lots of high resolution images and video and all of that, and we find we've got this massive file that now we need to transport to another machine or something like that. So I'm going to show you in Keynote here, version 8.0, how this works. I've got a presentation that has just a text slide here, some images, and a video. So there's something to be compressed. If I didn't have any of that in there, if it was just text, like you may have it say in a Pages or Numbers document, you may actually get a message when you try this saying that nothing can be reduced. But here, if I go to File and then Reduce File Size, I'll actually get all these options here. At the top it shows me the current file size, and when I check the file size in the Finder, that is indeed the current file size. The estimated size if I were to use the options below. So for instance, the most obvious thing here is a checkbox for scale down large images. And you can see when I move over it, I get a description of what it's going to do. So it's definitely going to reduce the image so that it doesn't have as much resolution, but it's fine for the screen. It looks the same on the screen. It's just not the super high resolution you would want, say, when printing. So you've got that. Under movie format, it can compress it for me using the standard H.264 or using the new HEVC, which is only something that works in High Sierra, the latest Macs. So if you are, you know, have total control, you're transferring this, say, to your laptop, and you know you've got HEVC, you may get a lot more savings there. Notice most compatible 17.1 meg. HEVC saves me more than 3 meg. So you can imagine if I had a whole bunch of video files here, how much that might save me. I can also say preserve the original format. In this case it was H.264, so there's no difference between these. Now when I do select this top one here, or even HEVC, I get more options. I can do 4K or 1080p, so I can drop a video that's 4K down to 1080. Also I get the option to do a draft quality, so it's really going to cut it down. You can see the entire movie now, or the entire presentation, is 4 megs. So this is not something you're going to want to use for your final presentation. It's not going to look as good, but it might be great for passing the presentation around to get approvals and things like that. So you set that up, and now you can reduce this file, which will get rid of, say, the high resolution version of those images, and it'll get rid of the original video and replace it with whatever it is you've selected here. Or you can reduce a copy, so you can save out a copy that's got the reduced size. Definitely if you're doing draft, you know, that you probably want to save out a copy instead. So you've got that. Now notice one of the options here is remove trimmed parts of movies and audio. So for instance, if I were to go to this slide here, there's the video, I go to movie, and then there's an edit movie option, and I can trim it. So if I only want to show this portion of the video, now I've trimmed it there. Now when I go to reduce file size, I can get a much bigger savings. You can see it's 10.6 megs. If I remove that option, it goes back to 17.2. So by trimming that video and saying I want to remove the trim parts of that video, I get a lot of savings there. So this is going to be a really useful feature if you end up with too big of a file and you need to do something with it. It's going to work great in Keynote. It could also work great in Pages, for instance, if you need to get approval for something and it's got a lot of high resolution images and the file is just huge. You can scale it down and still preserve, you know, mostly what it looks like, but maybe having a vastly smaller file size to send to somebody.